friends and family, and welcome to the Crippling Anxiety Global Pandemic Meditation Hour that lasts 10 minutes. For anyone who doesn't know me and happens to stumble upon this video, the basic premise is that this is not meditation instruction and I am not a meditation teacher. This is simply a discussion about meditation practices. Today I wanted to talk about something fairly simple, and the idea is one that is advocated strongly by a monk. He's dead now, from Burma. His title was Webu, and he taught lay people, which was not actually common at the time when he taught. And what he taught was Anapana meditation, very specifically Anapana meditation. He felt that if a person were to meditate Vipassana, that it could happen naturally and should happen naturally as a consequence of Anapana meditation. And his approach was incredibly straightforward. He would advocate for observing the breath just under the nose, and he would advocate for doing it all the time. He equated it to the lighting of a fire, that if you're starting a fire by generating heat from friction, you need to continuously do that thing. You need to be on your object of attention continuously until the fire is lit. He has other analogies and stories that he uses as well, but this idea of constant continuity, that a person should be with the breath all the time, can actually be taken from the other angle as well, which is that you can come to the breath anytime. And so if in these times you are finding that it is so difficult to meditate that you are avoiding it or simply not bothering, you can come to the breath in any moment. You don't need to sit cross-legged. You don't need to even close your eyes, although that may help at any given point. You can simply approach the breath anytime, anywhere. It's always with you. It probably won't do any harm to pay attention to your breath. If you feel like you're driving and it's going to be distracting for you, then don't. But otherwise, if you're in the bath, you're doing the dishes, you are watching TV, you're reading a book, even listening to someone, it's often the case that you will actually focus better on the activity that you're doing if you incorporate awareness of the breath. It's also possible just to stop whatever you're doing at any given point and incorporate awareness of the breath. We can try it now. three breaths, relatively harmless. We can go back to whatever it was we were doing after the fact. You can use this anytime. There's no rules around when and how you have to meditate. Anytime that you feel it would be beneficial to you, you can always go ahead. And so I do still think that it's extremely useful to give yourself 10 quiet minutes in silence in a secluded place twice a day if you can. But if you can't, you can always approach it from any other angle you like. So for today, you can take 10 minutes. If you have a timer with you, you can pause the video and we can run our timers together. I'll start mine now. That's our timer. Just a quick note, if you do want to read Webu Sayadaw's lectures, they have been translated into English and they're available in a book titled The Way to Ultimate Calm. They're very short and very digestible. They're kind of a nice set of reminders prior to meditating, or sort of a bedside nighttime reader kind of thing. If you're interested in that, I would recommend picking it up. I think you can get it just about anywhere. Amazon, Flipkart, etc. It's also available on the Party Yogi website, I believe. All right, everyone, take care of yourselves.